the group that identified the words that were told to watch in video, they would walk out of the laboratory slowly as if their body waited. And they had to go over it. It told us this incredible study, the power of words and the power of suggestion. And if you live in the environment, you're only going to hear a victim. What you begin to do is look for villains in the surroundings. So if you believe you're a victim, you're the villain. Our focus is people start to become the villains in the villainized plot. Now, it's not what that's really what you're doing. You know, we're victims. We know that real threats and real things that people face. What I have to help them speak in the victim mentality, here's what the enemy does. He starts to lie to us of the power of suggestion and fear controls the threat. For all that cause, you're not getting. If you know that you're a victim and you're surrounded by villains, it will justify your violence. If you believe you're a victim and you're surrounded by villains, the enemy allows you to justify the anxiety in your life. And what life is not in the shootings, one is going to be useful tool. The second is going to be high or impenetrable. It's that which binds you. So the end of the confusion is simply beautiful. So when you're seeing things, when you're seeing things, when you're seeing situations, you know what God is doing to you in every situation. What you know, what God was helpful in just becoming your point of interaction. And that's what the enemy does. We find an infinite cycle to start to create an influence as the state of the creation is in chapter 6. To appear and think, according to their oppressors, which is real and Midianites, and what the Lord does is guide you to reveal to the Midianites of idolatry in the midst of it. In order to be set free from the situation they're playing with us, or if you're living from it, you have to get rid of your idolatry. So the prophet comes in and wants the idolatry to work for part of you, because you have to return it because you want to take your heart out to other gods. Right after this prophet is right here, we see him quickly gives to them in chapter 6, verse 11. We see this giant oak tree in Ophrah. Not Ophrah. So we read in chapter 6, verse 11. It says this. Now the angel of the Lord sees him in the back of the oak tree at Ophrah. It's from Ophrah to Zelotash. Here we have this messenger who comes in. Now all the great ones who are to appear is the magic tree that many of them identify. Great winter of what we call the sacred oak, which is the angel oak, these massive trees. There are these massive oak trees that often some type of pagan practice would take place in. So what we learn is that there are actually significant material in this covenant that looks like that some type of pagan practice happened at this oak tree, but also no one comes to get an altar where they would often settle into these massive sacred oaks. The Joab is a leader in his heart, his offering to the kingdom of the Chargers. But there's nothing subtle in the speaker that makes written that he would get on the surface. The way that the minor judgment is written is, you're going to lose to something quite unique on the soul right. The way the messenger comes and sits under the oak tree indicates that the fact is written, it's about to be known. The beauty of this messenger, which we later find out the theology of Israel, as he sits down, and there is Israel's cry out for a deliverer, but are they willing to become under my people's story? I want to understand that you may be crying out for freedom in your life, but if you continue calling out for a deliverer, there is something that you want in your life. If God can make things clean and sovereign over your life, you can do it for him. You are trying to be captured. And so, this is a picture in the setup of the significant moment, verse 11 to 15. century, or not first century, but the 3,000 years, the 3,000 years of the Roman Church. So I mean, there's not this country for that the only thing that was in the Roman Church, I think you're going to have to go here, and chapter 12 of the Church of Paul. The theory that's the process. Here it is, saying that we start to be in the life of us. Here's what the ancient life of us would look like. What if it's 5 times in the darkness for the daytime? But you would never judge what you're trying to apply to your religious fancy. Have you ever thought you had a power of your own? Ever seen her have one something like that? Thank you. not by foundation with you, and show me a sign, and this is so strange. We have talked with you in such a much presence. So, we create the Jewish culture, obstacle culture, he knows it appears something like this, that's what I'm saying about it. He goes away. For the years of the crazy, he feels an entire code, he admits things to his voice, he walks a flower to 22% of the power. He thinks he's insane. And he tells him, he's doing what's in our hands in the situation, right? And here's the best jerk in all of you. Now we bring fire into the sacrifice of the offering of such a career, as you heard in the story of the sacrifice of the church. I have all the expenses of the fire. And those of the fire. And we were here through this fire. Sapphire and Jacob, the people's girls, and the people right now, Thank you. thing that's talking about living with Jesus. Not only do you have to feel free, you have to serve him. Take this moment to install unto you and say, God, do your work.